Hello friends, in this video lecture, we will try to understand basics of network management architecture. Starting of network management architecture deals with network management system, that is NMS. It concerns with network resources such as hubs, switches, bridge, router, gateway, connectivity, among them via network. As we all are familiar with all these things. For example, NMS is nothing but what? Network Management System, or we can say that is nothing but Network Manager, which will try to control all the service provider under them and which will try to control all the resources, or we can say customers. So NMS is nothing but the highest network element which is present inside the network. So inside network, two main things are present. One is nothing but devices, and second is nothing but data. Devices contain all the things like the connecting devices and the present devices used for the transmission purpose. For example, computer, laptop, mobile are nothing but what? The present devices used for the transmission purpose. And in the connecting devices, we can include the examples such as cables, fiber optical cables, etc. So that everything comes under the devices. And second one is nothing but what? Data. Data is the thing which should get exchanged in between the different devices. So both the type of things can get easily controlled by the NMS. Why? Because this is the highest element. And to connect all the device and for the transmission of this data, we require hubs, switches, bridges, router, gateway, and connectivity among them via network. So what is the work of all these things? Many times, whenever it is necessary to join or to make the connection between the different networks, then we require these things such as gateway, such as bridges, such as routers, etc. Also, many times the different devices present in the different networks may work on the different protocols. Then we required what? Gateway. So like this, each and every device, each and every connecting media has some features, some specifications. So we must have to go through them. A network consists of network component and interconnection. The vendor means what? Seller, who manufactures a network component or set of network component, is the best qualified to develop a NMS for the product. So seller, that means who wants to sell his products. So what kind of product it may be? The network output, network efficiency, network reliability, along with the use of the different type of quality of product known as the component, quality of service, each and everything depend on one another. And such kind of things should comes to the, or can be count to the basics of network management architecture. So this is all about why the NMS is used to observe or to maintain the resources and data, which is known as devices and data. This involves getting of data from each instance of a component in the network to one or more centralized location and displaying status on NMS. Now, what is the basic architecture? NMS is the main thing. After that, now here we have to understand there can be the different service providers. Fine. And there is a lot of competition between them. This service provider are nothing but what? Seller, that means vendor, who wants to sell their facility among the lot of customers. So what can they do? They all try to capture maximum customer from this area. So what is the first layer? NMS. What is the second layer? Service provider. And what is the third layer? Customer. So every service provider will try to provide the facility to customer. Now it is depend on the customer whose facility they have to buy or purchase. So centralized location is one, and Displaying status on the NMS, that means NMS having all the information about each and every service provider as well as each and every component which is present inside that network only. This should we have to understand that one NMS belongs to that network can contain the information only about the all the devices, that means all the things present inside the network only. If there is another network, then this NMS cannot having any status of this network. Again, there will be the other manager who will try to control the other network. He will having all the information. Indirectly, NMS is controlling it. NMS is storing the information, storing the data. That means what? IT managers, software engineers who try to design this NMS or who try to develop this network, that are having all the authority to observe, to control, to monitor, to solve, to resolve the problems present inside the network. In general, if we have to define the architecture, how can we define? First of all, there will be the manager. After that, there can be the multiple agents. After that, there can be the multiple network objects. Vendor A and vendor B will try to communicate with each other. For making the communication, one has to start to send a request that yes, we will start to make the communication. So establishment of the communication can be designed via request. Reply of the communication for the successful or failure establishment of the communication can be defined via response. And all these things are happen in between the different vendors or different customers or in between the vendor and customers. So NMS, network agent, network objects can be treated as sometimes vendor, sometimes customer. So everything can be designed or defined in the general architecture, such as NMS is the first priority device. So NMS can send a request or can start the communication by transmitting some data to the agent. Agents are not able to create the data. So who must have to start the communication? NMS. Hence, the direction is unidirectional. Agent now contains the data coming from the NMS and so that they can pass forward the data to the other network object. And so the direction is unidirectional from network agent to network objects. And such kind of architecture known as the basic layer architecture or the basic architecture for NMS. After this, if we try to observe in general, what are the layers which will give us the successful communication rate or the establishment, then the answer will be transport protocol, management protocol, and application services. As we all are familiar with the three types of model architecture for communication. First of all, OSI, second is TCP/IP, and the last one is TNA. OSI contains 7 layer of architecture, TCP/IP contains 4 layer of architecture, and TNM is having itself own basic layer of architecture which will try to overcome all the drawbacks of the OSI as well as TCP/IP. These are the layer architecture and this is depend on the model architecture. So these application service, management protocol, transport protocol will try to do the work at which layer they are situated. For example, transport protocol are situated in the OSI model. If at the layer number 4, then that will do the work of the layer number 4, function of the layer number 4. Similarly, management protocol are there like a CMIP, SNMP, they will try to do their work. And application service, that means conversion of the raw data into the suitable data which should get transmit or received in between the different vendors. And hence and only hence, to the application service layer, the vendors are connected directly. Otherwise, at these two layers, already they try to work on the raw data. And application service will take the data conversion from raw into the suitable format. And that suitable format is accepted by the vendor. and hence the direction is like this. So vendor can communicate directly with application service and they can also transmit something towards the vendor. So the direction is what? Bidirectional. And otherwise these two can communicate with each other. Transport layer will try to transmit something to management protocol, that will try to transmit something to the application service. They will do their functions, as we have already seen the functions of every layer, so that we know that the transport protocol will do what kind of function, management protocol will do what kind of function, and then that will be carry forwarded to the application service. So this is nothing but what somewhere we can say the deep architecture of the network management system. After this, in the theoretical world, what we can see, an NM, that is network management, an NM architecture for interoperability as shown in the above diagram, where the vendor exchange common management message. It consists of management information data, for example, type of the data, ID, status of the managed object, etc. Now, what it means by managed object? Managed objects are get easily controlled by the upper device. And so that always we have to select the managed object for the maximum efficiency of the network. So what it contains? The type of the data, ID, status of managed objects, etc. Management protocol are CMIP, Common Management Information Protocol, for OSI, and SNMP, Simple Network Management Protocol, for Internet Model. Internet model, that means that are from TCP/IP. So these two types of protocols are used to manage the network. What is the difference between CMIP and SNMP? This is the next thing which we have to understand, so that we can decide what kind of management protocol one must have to use for a particular application. The answer is, whenever we are going to use a CMIP, then suppose inside the network, if 25 devices are present, then CMIP is able to control and monitor the 25 present devices only. And what is meant by SNMP? Suppose inside your network, now the present devices are 25. Fine, that are getting controlled or monitored by the SNMP. Plus, if due to addition of some extra element in the future, the number of components inside the network are become 27, that means if two elements are added in the future, then also that get automatically controlled by the SNMP. And so that whenever your application is related with the random number of customers, which can get increased day by day, then one must have to go and use what? SNMP for the managed the protocol. So this is all about the basic architecture or selection of the components or protocol for the basic NMS architecture. Thank you.